Welcome back, everybody. Third Generation Wrestling Podcast, 3GW, back in the building. And it's a special occasion today. We'll talk about it here in a minute. But first, introduce ourselves. I'm DaReaL Big E, and this is Rob the Ambassador. How you doing, sir?
Doing good, man. Doing good. Here to celebrate this little milestone. I'm excited about it. Ready for you to talk about it.
Man, first and foremost, thank you all for subscribing and hitting that like button. We've noticed the change in the channel. We just hit it's a mild milestone, but it's a milestone for us either way. 100 subscribers, 101 to be exact as of right now, as I'm recording this. So if we couldn't, we appreciate you all. We really mean it. We love it. We're going to continue to put the content, and we're so glad you all are liking it. And can't say it enough. We will be continuing to, make the channel better with more equipment and things of that nature to kind of spice things up and make the channel even better. When we first started, we were strictly just an audio podcast. almost three years ago, I can't believe it. And all we did was talk wrestling. And then we kind of started to change. We had more people on, and then we started to say, well, maybe we should do YouTube. And we only put the audio on YouTube and some short clips from our shows. And then probably, 4 or 5 months ago, we decided, we should probably show another side of our personalities and do these other videos, talk about other topics and stuff. So that's kind of why we have the name 3GW. That's where we started. That's where we're going to keep. But we are going to continue to mold and change with the times and show these other sides of our personalities. So again, thank you all. And for those that are here for the wrestling, it's not going anywhere. We're just branching off and adding things to the chat. So.
Well, I just want to chime in and say thank you. Big E, when you asked me to do this, I had never done a podcast before. Not really comfortable really talking that much, but I loved wrestling. We both did. And so I tried it out. And with your encouragement and your guidance, I feel like I've come a long way doing this. The show has come a long way. And I know to a lot of people, 100 subscribers might not sound like a lot, but for us, it's a lot. We've been doing this for a few years, and it's taken us a little while to get here, but the numbers are moving, and we're going to keep doing what we're doing. And hopefully we keep these numbers going up. We hope you folks are enjoying it. And we're just, like I always say, we appreciate y'all. So thank you.
Yeah, seriously. I know lately we've only been putting out kind of one video a week. We are going to get that up to maybe two, at least twice a week to upload. A lot of changes in the last 3 months. So it's kind of hampered the amount of content we've been able to put out, but we know we got to, put some more out. We're aware, but we just wanted to make sure that we thanked you all. And tonight we're going to kick off this 100 plus subscriber channel with a new Try Not to Laugh challenge. I know a lot of y'all want to fart and preach, and we're not going to not do them anymore. We just want to, again, branch out, show other sides of our personality. Now, this right here is going to be just as, if not more difficult than the fart and preacher, because this was one of my favorite shows growing up. I mean, it was way before my time, but.
Oh, yeah.
I still watched the reruns when I was a kid, and I always laughed at Red Fox. So if you're watching, you know the title. You see what it says. This is a Sanford and Son compilation Try Not to Laugh Challenge. And I was listening to another podcast earlier, and they were talking about Sanford and Son. And I don't want to say what the line was, because it might be in the video, and if it is, I'm done. But there was a line with Fred talking to Aunt Esther, and I laughed for 15 minutes. I could not stop. Tears, I mean, everything. I could not stop. I was like, you know, working, people are looking at me like I'm crazy because, you know, all I got is the headphones in. Can't nobody hear what I'm listening to. But I don't know. I haven't seen this compilation. So I don't want to ramble on anymore. Rob, you got anything before we get into it?
Oh, no, man. I grew up on Sanford and Son. Actually got to see Red Fox perform in person at the Iowa State Fair.
Oh, nice.
Believe it or not. Yeah, I was just a child. Now, he's known for being a very dirty comedian. He kept it mostly clean, but a couple of bad words did get in there, though.
Yeah, he was more of a joke teller than a – he told some stories, but if you listen to his tapes and stuff, they were mostly jokes.
Yeah.
But if you were sitting in the front row, and he'd get on you, too. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, it was his delivery. And I remember the first time – this is the last thing I'll say before we get into it. First time I watched Harlem Nights – him and DaReaL, that back and forth about the orange juice, I was done. I laughed at that for 15 minutes too. So yes, highly recommend y'all check out Harlem Nights. And at the end of the video, we're gonna talk about the next thing we got coming up. It's another bad movie review that I know Rob's looking forward to.
Yeah, I just love these bad movies. They make for good podcasts, though, I'll say that.
They do. All right, sir. Ready to suit up?
Yep. I'm good to go.
I'll get that.
Hello, Fred.
Hello, Woody. Goodbye, Woody.
What are you doing that for? Hey, come on in, Uncle Woody. You too, honest.
Not until that heathen apologizer for slamming the door in my face.
Oh, God.
She's right, Pop. Apologize.
I apologize, Esther, for slamming the door in your face.
Well, that's better.
Fred, now, I wish you wouldn't do that.
What did I do?
Fred was just having a little fun, dear. Come on in. Did he hit your nose?
Try and be a little nice to Aunt Esther. I mean, after all, she is Mom's sister, you know?
Well, gang, Esther, on behalf of Elizabeth, please sit down and feel at home.
Thank you.
And Esther, on behalf of Elizabeth, would you care for something to eat?
Oh, I wouldn't mind a little snack.
Well, son, go in the kitchen and fix your Aunt Esther a fish head sandwich.
You can insult me all you want to now, Fred Sanford, because when I'm chosen Mrs. Watt's business wife, your insulting days are going to be over.
I didn't know that you entered in that contest.
I didn't only enter into it, I'm going to win it. Right, Woodrow?
Right.
Wrong. That's the first place you can enter that contest because you're not eligible. See, one of the things you have to be is a part of a certain race.
What race?
Human. Esther, do like I tell you. Forget about that. Bow out. Keep yourself.
Why did Woodrow look drunk already?
Why should I be embarrassed?
That brother played a wino in every show he was ever
in.
Win
that contest.
He played Ned the Wino in Good Times.
My body was blessed by Mother Nature, honey.
And as you got older, it was cursed by Father Time.
That did it.
Oh,
come
God.
On, bro, let's go. Now, come on.
No, you run along, Esther. There's something I want to discuss with Lamont.
Well, I'll go and do some shopping.
Goodbye, dear.
Oh, you call me dear.
Why should not call you dear? You look like Bambi's father.
You old weasel-eyed heathen.
Oh.
That's probably
no.
Her now. Now, Pop, try to be nice to her.
All right, get the dough.
Hello, Aunt Esther.
Hello, Lamont.
Hey, Uncle Woody.
Oh, that's all right, Lamont. I'll pull my arm.
Hello, Fred.
Hello, Woody.
Hello, Fred Sanford, and how are you today?
Fine up to now.
Will you stop that?
Okay, okay. I'm quite fine, Esther. And may I lie and say how nice it is to see you?
How's your neck on, Esther?
It's much better, thank you. May I sit down?
Certainly, I'll push the couch out on the freeway.
Never mind him. Sit down here and make yourself comfortable.
Thank you, Lamont.
You're welcome.
You're a nice nephew.
I know.
And you'll make a nice cousin.
What?
Tell him, Woodrow.
You tell him, Esther. It was your idea.
But you went along with it.
Well, because you insisted.
But you gave in.
Because you would have killed me.
All right, Daddy.
Daddy?
Daddy?
Daddy? Daddy?
Mm. No, you don't mean. I mean, you couldn't mean.
I mean.
You do?
Woodrow and I are gonna have a baby. Hey.
Well, somebody better call the zoo.
Would you stop?
That's all right, Lamont. Just leave me alone, because, honey, ain't nothing you, he can say or do to dampen my spirits.
Oh, I am going to be a mother. The zoo.
Watch it, sucker.
Hey, congratulations, Uncle Woody.
Thank you, Lamont. Now, this calls for a drink.
Congratulations on that.
Thank you, baby.
If she going to have a baby, you better call for a veterinarian.
What's the matter with you, Pop? How can you be so cruel on Esther and Uncle Woody on the happiest day of their life?
Because they're both too old and too ugly to have a baby.
You don't know nothing about babies.
Who? Fred G. Sanford? The G stands for Goo Goo Gaga. And gynecologist.
Well, it just happened, Mr. Fred G. Sanford, that we're not going to have this baby the way you had Lamont.
You gonna have this baby on purpose?
And that's cold.
I'm sorry, son. I mean, yeah. I never regretted it.
Thanks loads.
You see, Fred, what Esther means is we're going to adopt our child.
That's just what I mean.
Hey, adopting. Now, I think that's wonderful.
I do, too. I'll drink to that. You drink to ingrown toenail. To an ingrown toenail. Listen, Esther, let me ask you a question. Why you want this baby anyway?
We need one.
You need one? Why?
Because we have a conscience, Fred. We have a home and a business, and no one to give it to when we pass on.
Well, give it to me and pass on.
I understand perfectly, Aunt Esther.
I knew you would, Lamont.
Aren't you too old to start with a little baby?
Of course we are, Fred, and we're not going to adopt a little baby. We're going to adopt a teenager.
Do you know there are hundreds of orphan youngsters in this state that nobody wants?
And do you know there are two adults in my living room that nobody wants?
Pop, what's the matter with you? Can't you see that what Uncle Woody and Aunt Esther are doing is a wonderful thing?
Yes, it's wonderful, son. They're taking a child out the asphalt jungle and putting him in lion country safari.
Now, listen, Fred, you know, you really begin to get on my nerves now. Now, I've sat here and listened to you insult my wife long enough. So I'm gonna be waiting right outside where I don't have to hear.
Where I don't have to hear.
Hello, Smitty. Hey, brother, this is Lamont Sanford, man. Somebody robbed our house. Okay, thanks. Thanks a lot, Smitty.
What did he do, congratulate you?
No. He said he'd be right over.
That was fast.
Oh, Lord.
Hi, Lamar. Fred.
Forget Smitty, son. Call SWAT.
Shut up, heathen. Well, Fred, I see you finally got rid of all that old useless furniture in this house. But what are you still doing here?
Quick, son, get the raid so we can kill this fungus before it multiplies.
Will you stop that? Somebody robbed us, Aunt Esther. They really cleaned us out.
Well, I guess that's what they mean by good riddance to bad rubbish.
And I guess you what they mean when they say into each life some ugly must fall.
Watch it, sucker. Now, I didn't come here for no fight. I just came for a little donation for the church. But looks like I'm too late.
That's not true, Esther. Put me down for five.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Fred Sanford, $5.
Not $5, five knuckles.
Okay, old sinner. But just remember tonight, when you look around his empty house, just remember that the Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. High glory.
And you remember when you look in the mirror tonight, the Lord gave you that face and you stuck with it. Sitting Bull.
Sitting Bull. Fred,
where you get all busting in my door anyway?
I'm sorry, Fred. It's an emergency. I need help.
Help? I'm just a junk man, not a plastic surgeon.
Please, Fred, I need your truck.
I agree, son. You take the truck and run over Esther's face.
You are evil heathen. And one of these days, the Lord is going to strike you down if he ever decides to get his hands dirty.
What's the matter, Aunt Esther?
Our truck broke down, Lamont, and today is the day we're supposed to pick up our son.
Oh, that's right. I forgot. The adoption agency accepted you and Uncle Woody. Hey, congratulations. Listen, Aunt Esther, let me drive you over there in the truck because you got that whiplash. It'll be kind of painful for you to drive.
Thank you, Lamont.
Why don't you sit down here and make yourself comfortable?
No, don't sit down on my couch. I'll have to have it condemned.
Fred Sanford.
That's Fred G. Sanford. And the G is for glad you're going. Goodbye.
Well, looking at you, I thought the G stood for God forbid.
Say, shouldn't we be leaving, Aunt Esther?
You're right, Lamont. Let's go.
Oh, say, listen, Esther, why don't you just run along with Lamont, and I'll meet you back at the house later, okay?
Yeah, I think he's right on, Esther. There's only room for three of us in the truck.
Is this it? I mean, y'all get to keep the child forever?
Well, maybe. You see, he's gonna stay with us for about a year, and if everything works out all right, then the adoption agency will make a recommendation to the court.
I know we'll like him. I just hope he likes us.
I know he'll like you, Esther.
Why, thank you, Fred.
Children always love animals.
I love how he always sets
Fred
her up.
Fred Sanford, you are the lowest of the low, and the meanest of the mean, and the baddest of the bad.
And you are the ugliest of the ugly.
That did it. Get him, Woodrow.
Woodrow.
Bang, bang!
We better leave, Aunt Esther, if we want to pick up your son on time.
My son. Yes, I'm going to get my son. Forgive me, Fred Sanford, if I made you angry. I should be thankful that the Lord has smiled upon me today. And in return, I should smile upon all his creatures. Bad creature.
Bad bat.
Bat.
Glory.
Yeah, I knew I wasn't gonna make it through that.
Yeah, there's you know, the show was on for several years. You know, there's a lot. I thought they would be shorter clips and we would get
yeah,
more.
Yeah, I thought they would be too. I never seen that video, so I just
okay. I mean, it still had some funny moments, but there's I'm sure there's more out there. Maybe we'll try a different one next time, but that one was
kind of
want to
run the gambit here with, you know, a few different sitcoms. That's why I was asking about a few off mic. I think last week I was asking about a couple, but yeah, you know, we just branching out and then, you know, we'll mix the farting preachers in between, you know.
Yeah.
And like I said, we will be doing another bad movie review probably this weekend or the next couple of days. And it is going to be somewhat wrestling thing, but it's a movie that is so bad that it's got to be funny. I haven't seen it since it was in theaters. And talking about the Marine, John Cena. Have you seen the movie? Have you ever watched it?
I did see it when it first came out on video or DVD, probably it was at the time. You know, we're going to talk about it, so I'm not going to say too much, but, right. But I will say it is it's an action film, if you want to call it that.
It has the elements of an action movie, yes.
Yeah, so I'm an action movie fan. So, but look, long story short, I don't really remember the movie. That could be an indication of what I thought of it. But I'm curious to look at it again and, talk about it on the podcast.
Well, yep, it's going to be you, me, myself, and Doc. We're going to do this movie review.
Oh, Doc's coming on. Okay.
very, very interesting. Then we'll try to get more movie reviews more consistently. Like I said, more content is coming, promise. Thank you all again. Make sure you yet again hit that like button, subscribe, and share. Let us know. Did you all make it? Did you all enjoy this Trying to Laugh challenge? Do you want to see more of Stanford and Son? We will do them. If you have a recommendation for a sitcom, I know there's a lot out there, like Office, Family Guy, Cleveland, there's a ton out there. So, we're up for doing that, along with if you have a Farting Preacher recommendation, send it on over. Or a wrestling retrospective, we will do it. As long as you can send it to us, send us the season and the episode from Peacock so we can find it. Or if you want to be even go above and beyond, send us a DVD. But you can send us anything, your comments, your likes, dislikes, recommendations, opinions, thirdgenwrestling@gmail.com. Send us give us your feedback. You want to know how to do better. And make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Instagram is Third Generation Wrestling Podcast. And on Twitter at podcast_third. WrestleMania post show is up. And our WrestleMania 10 retrospective is up as well. So check those out. Ambassador.
Well, hey, I always say we love y'all. We appreciate y'all. Once again, so thankful that we made it to 100, 101. And so with 101 of y'all, one of y'all got to have a suggestion. So send it in because we'll do it. We're trying to grow the show still. We've reached this milestone, but there's more milestones to go. We want to reach them. So, yeah, give us some ideas. We will do the show. We promise you.
Right on, right on. Everybody have a great week. Take care. And we'll catch y'all next time. Peace.